Hello, everybody. This is a historic morning. Bitcoin just hit a new all-time high. But I'm not here to talk about Bitcoin today. And congratulations to everybody in Bitcoin. And it's always good to have multiple assets. And that's what we do here on the channel. But this is interesting. Ladies and gentlemen, we have something that is changing the way blockchains could act forever. Think blink of an eye. Think flap of a hummingbird's wing. That's how fast we could become. And yesterday I reached out to the community and said, who wants a video on this? And everybody said, yes. So let's get into it. This is called Instant Finality. And it is a little bit technical, but it's also very interesting. Thank you so much for being here. Thank you to the mods in the chat. Go. And let me see. I forgot to turn on my proper mic. That should be better. So this is about near instant finality. And shout out to Crypto Brando, longtime friend of the channel, watching since the beginning and Patreon member. You have changed our lives. Thank you so much. And yeah, it's the I feel like the Brad Pitt in the tank scene. Best job I've ever had. Although it's not a job. It's a purpose-driven life. So thank you all for coming. And I know it's early for most people. But we got some other stuff to do today, too. Let's get into the story and make this fast. This is, first of all, I'm going to touch on some Solana news before we get into the real meat. First of all, shout out to the Chainlink fans. CCIP, which is a revolutionary RWA tokenization of everything, Oracle capability from Chainlink, is now live on Solana. Okay, this will not only supercharge the growth of Chainlink, But it'll also help DeFi as well. We have Pith on the Solana ecosystem as an oracle, and now the massive 800-pound gorilla Chainlink as well. So this is great for both names and interoperability. And as Mert, friend of the channel, says, everybody is expanding to Solana. I wonder why. Maybe because the best, cheapest, fastest. And that's what I've been saying since 2021. So let's get into the story, too. Solana is the number one in terms of social media mentions, excluding Bitcoin. Bitcoin is still the king of the hill because, you know, governments and nation states, etc. But Solana is number two, absolutely smoking everything else as well. It's good to see Solana has four times the mentions of XRP, and XRP is not even a blockchain. So moving on. Solana ETFs, sadly, Blazo, thank you, buddy. Sadly, Sol ETFs are delayed for now. And I know people are losing hope, and I know they're watching Bitcoin hit all-time highs, and they're saying, what's happening with Solana? But remember, we need to be patient, ladies and gentlemen. But the SEC has delayed the decision for 21 shares, Bitwise, VanEck, and Canary Capital for the spot Solana ETF. But the good news, there's still an 88% chance it's going to come in 2025, you just need to be patient. And when that happens, considering how much Solana is staked, we're talking 66, 67% of all Solana staked, and now we've got Solana treasuries as well, it's going to be hard to bail the big bag of Solana. Anyway, one thing as well, just a warning to everybody to be very careful out there. Wintermute, beware the Wintermute flush. Shout out to Marty Party. And this is from Solana News in the past 24 hours. Binance has sent 477,701 SOL to Wintermute. By the way, I monitor their wallet. They have nearly 700,000 SOL that they could use at the flick of a switch to suppress the price and liquidate longs, or the opposite. Anyway, so just be careful out there. Remember, these folks are hunting for your bags. If you play with liquidity, be very careful. And let's get into the big news. This is from Anza XYZ and introducing the largest Solana protocol change ever, ever. Say goodbye to Tower, BFT, and Proof of History. Proof of History is what first got me intrigued to Solana, by the way, so I'm a little bit sad to see it go. But say hello to Votor and Rotor, and we'll break down exactly what that means in simple terms, too. Now, why is this revolutionary? First of all, the easy way to think about it, break it down, shout out to Sanjay too, is three simple pillars. And if you know me, I like threes. So first of all, as you know, Mert and Tolly say, always don't waste bandwidth. Two, decide fast. And then number three, probably most importantly, split faults into two. And that way you can deal with some other things that could potentially happen on crypto, like nefarious activities. Now, what they're doing is they believe it's a groundbreaking upgrade to Solana consensus, again, replacing that proof of history. And it enables ultra-fast, ultra-reliable transaction and optimized voting. You don't need all the votes to make it happen. And it dramatically increases transaction finality, dramatically, to 150 milliseconds. We'll talk about what that means. But just for perspective, everybody, this is what 150 milliseconds means. When I compare in our crypto compendium and SCP profiler, the speed, we can compare any chain to any chain, and you can do it yourselves too. The finality, which is one of the most important things for crypto and blockchain, especially in finance, DeFi, payments, etc., it's 360.3 seconds for Ethereum. For the kids at home, your math problem for the day is, how many minutes is that? And for Solana, it'll go to 0.15. That's 150 milliseconds. Unfortunately, the system here rounds it up to 0.2. But the big takeaway from this is this new finality from Alpenglow on Solana will increase the finality of Solana 240,000%. I'll repeat that. 250,000% faster finality than Ethereum. Okay? This is the difference. Other fun stuff there you can see too. Nakamoto is 20. Ethereum is 2. Transactions per second, theoretically up to 710,000. Max TPS of ETH is 45, but really it runs at 15. Daily transactions. Solana does 8,000% more daily transactions. Solana has 1,200% more daily active users. This is kind of crazy when you consider that Solana trades at a fraction of the market cap of ETH. And I know markets are irrational, but one day they won't be. We need to get ready for that. Yes, happy all-time high day as well. Woohoo, I love that. From, who's that? Crypto Dave. Woohoo. Congratulations, everybody. And we love all assets, by the way. So let's talk about a little more technical stuff. The rotor replaces turbines multi-layer with a single layer. Remember, this change is happening on the layer one. It's not a layer two or other type of hack solution. And it'll help real world TPS go at least to 65,000 TPS and a lot higher without layer two complexity. And as we discovered before, when you compare it to other chains, Bitcoin runs at 7 TPS, Ethereum 15 TPS. Again, it's not even in the same league. Now, we will talk about other chains in a minute too. But one of the things that is very important is resilience and security. So this new 20 plus 20 resilience model tolerates up to 20% adversarial and 20% non-responsive validators. Basically, it can mean only 60% are actually running and you can still have the same speed and reliability. This is very, very important. And this also reduces the reliance on the cryptographic clocks, which were under proof of history in the past. Again, very, very important. Also, why do we care? Because this changes things like online gaming, things like DeFi, things like payments, and we'll get into exactly some comparisons in a second. But first, real-time application development. A lot of people are talking about the gaming application for this. 150 milliseconds is wicked fast. Absolutely wicked fast. You could have lag-free on-chain gaming, gambling, NFT transactions, real-time DeFi, etc., with faster than Web 2 level performance. People say, what's Web 2? Well, that's like Visa and stuff like that. And also, it'll be revolutionary for things like stock exchanges, DeFi, again, payments, stablecoins, all that type of stuff. Absolutely huge. And also cost efficiency for validators because it reduces the minimum validator stake from nearly 5,000 SOL down to 450, 90% decrease. The amount of money to get started as a Solana validator is only $76,000. You need 32 ETH. Let me turn off my little graphic here. 32 ETH to be a minimum staker for Ethereum as well. And that's about 84. So 76K, 84K. Now we are kind of on par with Ethereum for setting up a validator. But the good news is, Solana already has over 2,000 validators, and this will help them get an awful lot more in the very near future too. Now, I'll turn off my little image again. A couple of things. Why the Solana lead becomes unsurmountable. There is no chain that comes even close. Well, there wasn't any before, with the exception of Finality, which was a little bit of an Achilles heel, which I'll talk about, and the nearest competitor. But now Solana is far and away the best. Again, Web2 competitive performance smokes everything. Visa, NASDAQ, Binance, you name it, without complex layer two solutions. Also enhances the scalability from the layer one, and it makes things a lot cheaper. Reduced validator requirements, very ultra low transaction fees, and it makes crypto and blockchain more accessible globally for micropayments and other good stuff too. And the ecosystem will get even stronger working with Google, Stripe, Shopify, etc. for all sorts of payments. All of the world of finance is coming to blockchain. It has to make it cheaper and faster. And the new benchmark of 150 milliseconds is, again, like nothing the world has ever seen. Now, let's have a little bit of a comparison here. I just want you to cast your eyes on the little chart I made on the left. You've got Solana Alpenglow, 150 milliseconds. Visa, 200 milliseconds. Ethereum, well, you know, Ethereum's about 6 minutes. And Bitcoin is about 10 minutes. So it's a different league altogether. But the key there is the transaction finality speed breakthrough means Solana was now faster than Visa. And Visa is the fastest. Okay, that's the most important thing as well. Now, getting back to Sol versus Sui, for the longest time, I always said, this is terrible. Sui finality is faster than Solana. Well, that's all about to change. This model is not updated for the... And the reason I did that was this shows you the current finality, 1.3 seconds versus Sui, half a second, 500 milliseconds. But soon, Solana will be 0.15 versus 0.5. So the only area where Sui was actually stronger than Solana was this finality, and that is soon to be put to bed as well. And again, other stats there, you know, Solana does 2,000% more transactions, has more TPS, et cetera, et cetera. You get the idea. It's also a lot more decentralized if people care about that. And Toli is thrilled because Alpenglow is simple, fast, and reliable. And by the way, I paraphrased his technical jargon, so Toli, I hope you're okay with this. But it makes life, the easy way to understand exactly how this thing works is it makes life easier for both users to get quick confirmations, which is so important. By the way, if you've ever sent Bitcoin and you wait 10 minutes to know if it actually got sent, can be kind of nerve-wracking in those little 10 minutes, if you know what I'm saying. But also, it'll help engineers deal with a lot less complexity. So the easy analogy I'm trying to put together so you all get what this means is it's a super smooth highway system, okay? The cars are the transactions flying around. They move quickly. There are no traffic jams. There's no congestion. And the road crew that keep the road running have a much easier time maintaining it, i.e. the developers or the engineers. That's the easy way to think about it. And again, nothing touches what these folks have actually done. And then I hear you ask, when Alpenglow this year? Well, according to the team in their presentation yesterday, it's 2025, ship or die. They are now revealing it. Then there's the SAMD, a little bit of testing, and then launch. So fingers crossed, it'll be out. And by the way, there is always a seasonality with Solana. It always saves the best to last. I remember saying a couple of months ago that Solana's been very quiet. Something is bubbling up under the surface. Well, this is it. This is it. And that sets us up for Solana summer, which is great, and all the good stuff that follows after that too. So very quick little conclusion here. A beautiful little table that kind of tries to summarize it. Solana uses the turbine for block propagation, which relies on erasure coding, but limited historically by leader bandwidth. But with Alpenglow, this uses the optimized rotor to spread bandwidth across multiple leaders, again, taking away the traffic jams and the bottlenecks. And this tower BFT also requires 32 votes for finality in 13 seconds, but under Alpenglow, it cuts this to 100 to 150 milliseconds by needing fewer votes for finality. And again, it improves fault tolerance, latency, bandwidth efficiency, making the network even more faster, even more resilient and less dependent on high bandwidth leaders. Okay, it democratizes everything. Quick conclusion. If you want to know what Alpenglow is, it's more secure, faster, even than Web2 Visa. It is cheaper. It's going to be cheaper. It's going to become more decentralized because the requirement for validators is coming right down. And it's going to be capable of NASDAQ and faster, which was the original mission. Remember, we're getting ready for Solana summer. Be patient. Shout out to Indigo Hammer, who put this up this morning. A little bit embarrassing. This is not my body. My old body powers. No, I'm kidding. But just a guy on the internet. Reminder, not financial advice, but also we're getting ready for Solana summer, ladies and gentlemen. It's going to be pretty good, I reckon. Hope you like the video. Quick intro to Alpenglow. Thank you, everybody, for coming as well. And we'll see. This one could take a little while to percolate through the system. But we've got a lot of tailwinds. We've got Fire Dancer still coming. Alpenglow. We've got ETFs. We've got the treasuries. It couldn't be better. Doesn't reflect the actual price. $172.25 right now. Did hit 174 earlier. And let me check on the Bitcoin price too. Bitcoin still above 109,000. Yeah. And by the way, just regarding the Bitcoin price action, it's kind of fascinating to me. I've been watching the last 2 or 3 days. Every single little dip is bought up. There was a little bit of manipulation last night during the night, around midnight. They wait for everybody to fall asleep and then they whack it down. So be careful if you're playing with perps on Solana or Bitcoin. They're hunting for your bags. Hope you enjoy the show. See you all tomorrow. Have a good night.